Hello, my name is Tomáš and I am from Capturing Reality. In today's episode we will learn basics about user interface of RealityCapture. What will we learn today? What is Ribbon and Workspace? What is RealityCapture logo for? What is Quick Access Toolbar? Where is About section of RealityCapture? Basics RealityCapture tabs and workflow explanation? How you can access Help section? Workspace layout and what are layouts for? What are context tabs? Okay, now we are in RealityCapture. RealityCapture user interface is divided into two main sections. This upper section is called Ribbon and this lower section is called Workspace. Let's start with Ribbon section. In the upper left corner we have the logo. When you click on it, this menu will appear. Here we can find recent projects, we can create new one, open or save it. We can also exit it with this icon. Then we have Quick Access Toolbar. By default RealityCapture have these layouts. There is also Undo, Redo and you can edit it here. When you click on more commands, you can customize shortcuts. For example, I can create a user shortcut for certain command. And I can also add more quick access shortcuts here. Here we can also find about section. Here you can find information about RealityCapture version, active user email and other information. Now let's take a look on workflow tab. Workflow tab is divided into some parts. The first one is add imagery. Here you can import your inputs, then you can process them, export them, and there is also application setting. In workflow tab, there are only high-level options for faster workflow. For example, we can import images, folders, laser scans, and so on. You can also drag and drop these items here. Then we have a process tab. Here you can align images, create model. But if you want to get more advanced view about these, there are other tabs to do that. There is alignment tab. Here are more advanced settings about alignment. Every section and tools have their own settings. When you click on them, this menu will appear. Then we can also align images, create constraints and georeference your scene, analyze your alignment, create selections of point cloud, and you can also export alignment. Then there's import section where you can import your component and flight logs and other things. When you have your alignment ready, we can go to calculate model. If you want more advanced options, let's go to reconstruction tab. Reconstruction have their own settings too. You can access it by clicking here. When you have created your model, you can now texture it or colorize it. Here are settings for it. Then you can also create selections and use other post-processing tools which you can find here. After that you can export your mesh with textures or import your model here. Application have their own settings too. Here you can find global application settings. The last thing that is on workflow tab is Map Wizard. Map Wizard is easy wizard workflow and method for mappers. You can process and do this all task I've described earlier with this map wizard here. Now let's talk about workspace. Workspace is this section here. The first thing that will appear here is help. Here you can type whatever you need to know about RealityCapture. For example, when I type here UI, these search results will appear. Here I can read more about user interface. In workspace, there are two main sections. The first one is this layout and this layout. On the left side, there is a scene view. You can choose between 1D SView, which is also 1D scene view, and 2D scene view. In 1D scene view, you can have a list of your entire project and your creations. In 2D SView, you have more visualized stand for your project, and you can also access your EXIF data, which are here. In 2D SView, you can also find this grid of images and data. On the right side, there are layouts. You can also divide these layouts to more sections. For example, let's change the view. Now I have four views. I can also resize these and adjust to my taste. You can change views by left-clicking here, holding, selecting your desired view and releasing. Now I have 1D view active. 1D view is setting like information for setting input, and it will also create a context tab. Context tab is a tab that changes when I change selected view. For example, now I have selected 1D view. If I will select 2D view, it will change to 2D view. Now let's talk about 2D view. It's right here. 2D view will visualize images, UV maps, orthographic projections, and so on. You can zoom here, change position, and so on. You can also open 2D view in multiple layouts. Then we have a 3D view. 3D view looks like this. You can change the rotation of your model. You can zoom in, zoom out, and you can also access gizmos. Now I have auto projection tool opened and I can resize this widget box, also called gizmo, like this. I can also create another gizmo like this and change rotation of the model. With 3D view, I can visualize my calculated 3D model and search for defects and verify the process of reconstruction. The last but not least, we have 4D view. We can access 4D view here. My quick tip is to use 4D view in timeline mode. For example, when I have this kind of layout, I can access 4D view like this. And now it looks like a timeline. Here I will enable 3D view, and now I can create an awesome walkthrough video-like animation. Then we have a map view, which looks like this. Here I can visualize my model right in the map. Then I have 1D view. This will give me access to my map provider name and other information. And the last view is console view. Console view can be used, for example, when I need to calculate my model and I need more information about steps that are currently processing. For example, when I now click on calculate model, I can minimize this window. And when we look right here, I can see the process. By the way, while it's processing, I can also go to this scene context tab, show progress back. I can minimize it and work on the project as it was not processing. What I cannot do is another processing such as alignment. It is grayed out. Okay, today we have learned about basics of user interface in Reality Capture. If you want to learn more about Reality Capture, press F1. To access help section, here you can type whatever you want to know about Reality Capture. So, for example, when I have tapped user interface, you can access it right here. If you like this episode, please like, subscribe and comment what you want to see next. Also follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and LinkedIn. I'm Tomáš and thank you for using Reality Capture.